I hope the Trump camp will come out and preach economics. That is all that matters. People on the radio try to get me to talk about social stuff. What about homosexuals? I don't care. What about abortion rights? I don't care. What about the economy? Uh-oh, I care a lot because I want to eat. I want to have a job. I want to have my kids have jobs and go to colleges. That's the only thing that Trump needs to come down on. And if he makes that case and he's honest with the American people, I think he'll get all the Sanders people, some of the Clinton people, and they should get all the Republicans. Should is, of course, a dangerous word.
Especially in these economic especially in these political times, I should say. Let's talk a little bit about the Society to Advance Financial Education, how it started, how people can get in touch with it. I just did a quick Google search just now as we've been talking, and you're everywhere. Facebook, LinkedIn, Meetup. You have so much going on with this organization. Tell everybody about it.
Well, what happened? You and I lived through the debacle of 2008 and 9 when the mortgage meltdown led to a market meltdown, led to all kinds of problems. I'd spent my life on Wall Street. I'd made a good deal of money, and so I came out of that with really three choices. I could retire, I could go back to Wall Street and make money, or I could try to do something to truly provide help to people. And as I looked at the outcome of that 2008 and 9 debacle, I started writing about financial education, and I wrote about don't sell in the bottom of a bear market. That's when all the buyers should be there. I wrote to people about the quantitative easing and what that will really mean, about what gold really does in times of fear. So I started writing, and that all evolved into the Society, which is a registered 501c3 not-for-profit.
And if you go to the website, it's a long one, societytoadvancefinancialeducation.org.
And we simplified. You can actually go to safefinancial.org. Safefinancial.org.
Nice. Okay. Got to update those search engines, guys. Safefinancial.org. You'll find all great information on the site. News articles, YouTube videos, resources that you can find that will really help you out in not only educating you, but arming you with the tools that you'll need. You can also, check out Facebook, LinkedIn, and you can check out, I rarely plug the competition, Steve, but check out Steve's radio show Sundays in the Chicagoland area, right? What time and what station, pal?
It's at 8 o'clock on AM 560, The Answer. You can see the video of it at stevebeaman.com. And my friend, I don't consider it competition. I consider what you and I do to be complementary of each other. And we both want to share a message of hope and liberty to people, and there can never be too much of that.
Way to ruin the joke, Steve. No problem. in all seriousness, folks, Steve is also on The Answer, you can check it out online. It broadcasts nationally through The Answer's website. I believe it's conservativeradio.com or something like that. I'll make sure that we get it during the show and make sure we promote everything. And, of course, stevebeaman.com. Steve, this has been a pleasure to finally talk some policy with people. Hopefully this will be what Trump does. And, to some extent, what Hillary Clinton does, because I firmly believe the more she talks policy, the more she's going to lose.
Absolutely.
And I think you kind of nailed that for me.
Let's bring the honest thing to the American people. Let's show them what they're going to get. I mean, this idea, we have two ideas, the Austrian economic view, which says people should keep their own money, the Keynesian view that says government should be the stimulating factor. Pick it. We've seen one. We've seen the other. You pick it from what you want to do.
And that's what elections should be all about. Steve, thanks so much for coming on.
Thank you, and Godspeed to you and your listeners.
Hello and welcome. My name's Andre Walker, and your weekly monologue starts right now. This was the week the newly appointed British Prime Minister, Theresa May, decided to create separate prison wings for Islamic fundamentalists to stop them radicalising other prisoners. As ever, I have my own thoughts on how these blocks could be different from the rest of the prisons they're housed in. Now, I'm not some heartless lunatic like George Bush. After all, we don't want another Guantanamo Bay. The British version should have all the facilities your friendly local terrorist might ever need. For example, I think they ought to be afforded 3 square meals a day of, say, bacon sandwiches, followed by lovely pork chops for main course, and ham crumble with custard for dessert. Yummy! And perhaps for breakfast, they could have Spam Flakes. They sound so good. Religious worship would, of course, be supported, even encouraged, Daily services in the prison chapel would be conducted by volunteers from the Westboro Baptist Church. We know they're not keen on fags, but I bet they really like 7th century Islamofascists. Entertainment would be provided by the prison library, which would be named after Tim Robbins, following his really realistic portrayal of life in prison in The Shawshank Redemption. He's also popular among jihadis because of his left-wing views. They want to behead him rather than torture and behead him, which, believe me, is a real honour. The library would be stocked with every single Will and Grace box set, as well as all 5 seasons of Queer as Folk USA and 2 seasons of Queer as Folk UK, plus every single episode of Queer Eye for the Straight Guy, just in case they're trimming the beard and thinking of a restyle. Music would be from Billy Joel, Neil Diamond, Barbara Streisand, Pink, and in fact the entirety of the Billboard Top 20 Jewish Artists in America. Oh yes. But what of their sexual needs? Well, that would be catered for by Napoleon, the black mule foot pig, whose offspring also supplies breakfast, lunch and dinner. But watch out, boys. Be sure to wear a condom. You don't want to risk being related to your own breakfast. This week saw CNN Politics run the following headline. Trump wants GOP to court black voters, then slams voting rights for felons. Yes, that's right, guys. I'm not joking. This holier-than-thou liberal media outlet is actually saying that all black people should be angry that felons cannot vote. Come on, CNN! What are you saying about black voters? Has it crossed your mind that the majority of black people in America aren't felons, don't know any felons, and have no desire to have the same voting rights as felons? To be fair, though, CNN might as well give up anyway. If President Obama ridicules you at the White House Correspondents' Dinner for not being proper journalists, you really, really have hit rock bottom. That said, though, I did like an article they published this week on their 20 best one-liners from the Edinburgh Festival this year. On the list was this from Michelle Wolf. Hillary Clinton has shown that any woman can be president as long as your husband did it first. Not exactly sparkling comedy. I preferred the felon gag myself, and that wasn't even intended to be a joke. That's the monologue. Make sure you visit andrewalker.uk this week, because I've published a handy guide for all you liberals of what punishments various countries have for homosexuality and how much those same regimes have given to the Clinton Foundation. Just time, though, for last week's quiz. We asked you how an African-American can help improve the lives of black people in the USA. Donald from New York thought it was to get down to Louisiana and help the clear-up. Sorry, Donald, but the correct answer was sent in by George from Hungary, who correctly worked out it was to join Black Lives Matter, smash up your own neighbourhood, loot your local shops, and spray bullets at your local police. It was just so obvious. I'm shocked so many of you found it so hard to guess. But either way, a pamphlet on ethical capitalism in global financial markets is winging its way to George, so well done. Until next week, goodbye.
Check out Andre's column at townhall.com. Check him out on Twitter at AndreJPWalker. And read Andre's work behind enemy lines.
Gene and Russ, back behind enemy lines. Folks, thanks for listening to the show. We're a little past halftime here, but I want to make sure that everybody knows that we thank you for listening to Behind Enemy Lines Radio. I'm Gene, he's Russ. Russ wants me to let everybody know that it's shirtless selfie radio this week because, well, Anthony, when you can do it, then pretty much anybody else can do it. But since you're listening to the show and you're picturing us with no shirts on, be sure to check out www.behindenemylinesradio.us. Check us out on the Facebooks and the Twitters at BEL underscore radio. And if you miss any part of this show when we broadcast live Tuesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern on Spreaker, you can check us out at any one of our rebroadcast outlets, including WJHC 107.5 FM in Jasper, Florida, or WDDQ 92.1 FM in Adel, Georgia, both part of the Red Nation Rising Radio Network on our terrestrial side, but there's also the internet side of Red Nation Rising. Check us out there as well. KLRN Radio, High Plains Talk Radio and Sackheads Media, and ICRN, the Internet Conservative Radio Network, as well as Lanterns Radio. We're happy to be part of the Lanterns family there. And if you miss us on any one of those rebroadcast outlets, check us out via podcast on iTunes, Spreaker, TuneIn, Stitcher, Podbay, Player FM, discover us on Google Play Music, and of course, as always, on iHeartRadio. Really? Shirtless, selfie, radio.
Are you really going to post those pictures we took on the website?
Why'd we take them if we weren't going to post them?
All right, let's do it, Gene.
They'll be up later, don't you worry. Don't you worry.
And by the way, I know Gene just spit out a whole bunch of places that you could hear us, but I'll tell you where the action's really at. It's in the chat room. So if you can tune in on Tuesday nights at 10 o'clock, behind enemylineradio.us, it's a blast in the chat room.
You know, because of the summer and some things going on in both our lives, we had to take some days off to do the show. We'll be pumping it out on the regular just as we start heading into the fall, folks. Programming note, next week, I'm going to Value Voters Summit. Unfortunately, Russ can't make it, per the usual, but whatever. I'm not bitter. going down there, we'll be bringing some great interviews from there in about 2 weeks. And listen, Russ is back for the duration now, so we got some great stuff to do.
And for those of you guys who don't know, because I do mention this every time Gene brings up Value Voters, Gene caused quite the ruckus a couple of years back at Value Voters.
Oh, I caused the ruckus on the Twitters, though, didn't I?
Basically, you was called a heathen and a whole bunch of other.
Oh, perverts, yes, because I was because I said that we felt like going to a strip club after going to Value Voters because we had to balance it out. Yeah, I mean, that happened.
They didn't get the joke. So,
listen, it's all in good fun around here. Get used to it, especially if you're going to be a listener of us for every week, no matter where you listen to us on any one of our outlets. But back to the show, Russ. We've had some cray. We've had some wonk to kind of balance out the cray, thanks to Steve Beaman and the Society to Advance Financial Education. Boy, that's a mouthful. And, of course, he has his own show, but we don't really want to talk about that. But let's get back to something that was initially thought to be cray, but may not be. Donald Trump was going around saying that he doesn't think he's going to lose state, whatever, you know, Pennsylvania, whatever state it is, unless they steal the election from him. Of course, that's crazy, Rustic. No one can steal an election.
Who's the they?
You know, they.
All right.
They. The ubiquitous they.
Because there is some truth to what he's saying.
There may be, because the FBI has stated through different reports that they've identified cyber attacks on at least two state election boards. Huh? Could that be the ubiquitous they?
I know that's
trying
the topic
to steal an election.
I know we're going
to
talk about this, but just for Donald's sake, and by the way, Daniel, good to see you in the chat room. I hope you're all right, buddy.
For yes, Donald's he's back. Sake, excellent.
Donald was really think about the time and place in which he said that statement. First of all, the Republicans did in fact try to steal the election from Donald Trump. That's Exhibit A. Exhibit B: Democrats, Barack Obama, Hillary Clinton admitting 10,000 Syrian refugees. Unfettered illegal immigration, striking down voter ID laws, stealing elections much? I think so.
Well, here's the latest news that you can add to that list, Russ. Department of Homeland Security wants to have jurisdiction over the presidential election. The Secretary of Homeland Security, Jeh Johnson, because it's spelled J-E-H, so we're going to go Jeh Johnson, says that, quote, we should carefully consider whether our election system, our election process, is critical infrastructure, like the financial sector, like the power grid. Does he not know what the Constitution says about,
in all fairness, Gene,
elections?
I can almost guarantee you if I go to Infowars.com right now that there's going to be a story about this. And you called Alex Jones crazy. Crazy? This sounds pretty crazy to me. If I didn't read this myself,
it's a big issue that states run elections.
I do, but I'm saying
that's what he said.
The fact that you're telling me that a department of the federal government wants to hijack that power that's not constitutionally granted to them in any way, shape, or form, I would call you crazy, and I would call you a conspiracy theorist, and I would say you were just flat out nuts.
Is it ignorance or is it a plot? That's what it comes down to. I'm leaning more
connect
towards
the dots. What
connecting
do you think?
The dots on this one. I mean, agree with you on this.
It is what it is. I mean, Barack Obama, the left wing, Hillary Clinton by default, they say lots of crazy things. Remember when Barack Obama was running for office, he said he wanted a civilian defense force that would rival the militaries.
And then George Soros has a memo leaked from one of his think tanks talking about national police regulations. And that's the start of possibly a national police force.
And Alex Jones talks about FEMA taking, you know, FEMA prison camps being set up secretly across the country. All right, that's a little over the top.